Gracias, mi amigo Horacio, the president of Paraguay, Horacio Cartes Saa. Thank you, my friend, for making this bold decision to move your embassy to Jerusalem. You said you would do it, like someone else I know. Hello, Ambassador Friedman. Like President Trump, you said you'd do it, and you did it. Thank you. When we spoke about it today, I said that Jerusalem has been the capital of the Jewish people for 3,000 years, the capital of the State of Israel for 70 years, and you said, my decision merely recognizes history. That's true. It recognizes history, but it also recognizes common sense. We have wonderful cities in Israel. One of them is Tel Aviv, a truly cosmopolitan city, a city of high tech, a city of enormous creativity. Tel Aviv is cherished in our hearts. But Jerusalem is our capital. So you moved your capital from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem, following history, common sense, and truth. Thank you. Thank you, Horacio. Our friendship is expressed in so many ways. We recognize and remember the role that Paraguay played in saving Jews before the Holocaust, during the Holocaust, receiving Jewish refugees after the Holocaust. As it turns out, today was not only a meeting of nations, it was a meeting of families. And my wife's family, very few survived the Holocaust. One of them came here, her father, my late father-in-law, and another went to Paraguay. And it turns out that the distinguished delegation here, which includes the distinguished ministers and the ambassadors and others, they know the Tauber family. So first of all, I want you to give them our regards. Second, tell them next year in Jerusalem. And we are very grateful for the role that Panama has played. I speak on behalf of all those who are present here, the ministers of the Israeli government, deputy minister, the foreign ministry, our ambassadors, our national security advisor. We all welcome this friendship. Today we had the opportunity to discuss it in great detail, and I want you to know that we are moving ahead because we believe in Paraguay. The way you believe in Israel, we believe in Paraguay. We know that it's one of the most advanced economies in all of Latin America. We know that you seek a better future for your people. You have wonderful plans. You've begun to execute them. We want to be part of this. We think that the combination of Israel and Paraguay can lead to great things for both our peoples and for South America. So we intend to make good on it, and I can say next year in Asunción. Mr. President, you have joined the historic decision of President Trump. He has changed policy in fundamental ways, not only on Jerusalem, but also on Iran. If you asked most of the governments and most of the leaders in the Middle East, what is the principal barrier to peace? What is the greatest threat to our security? They would say three things: Iran, Iran, and Iran. And President Trump has taken a firm position, which we welcome, against Iran. It was echoed by him and today by the Secretary of State, Mike Pompeo. Very strong position. No enrichment, tough sanctions, and Iran should get out of Syria. We believe this is the right policy. We believe it's the only policy that can ultimately guarantee the security of the Middle East and peace in our region. And we call on all countries to follow America's lead here, because Iran is an aggressive force. If Iran wanted to seek peaceful nuclear energy, they would need not a single centrifuge. They don't need centrifuges for enrichment. If Iran wanted to pursue a peaceful program, nuclear program, they would not hide their secret archives for making nuclear weapons. The first thing that de Klerk did in South Africa when he destroyed their nuclear program, the first thing he destroyed was their archive. The first thing that was destroyed when the Libyan nuclear program was stopped was the archive. But Iran did not destroy the archive. Iran hid the archive, lied about it, moved it from place to place because they are seeking nuclear weapons and conquest. The American position prevents them from having nuclear weapons and breaks the cash machine that they were using to fund their conquest of the Middle East. Thank you, America. This is the right policy. המדיניות של ארצות הברית היא נכונה. איראן נמצאת בתנופת התפשטות ותוקפנות בכל המזרח התיכון. היא שואפת להשיג נשק גרעיני באמצעים שונים שחשפנו אותם. המדיניות של הנשיא טראמפ היא נכונה. אפס ההשערה, אין צורך בזה. וגם איראן צריכה לצאת מסוריה. אנחנו מאמינים שזו המדיניות הנכונה. אנחנו קוראים לכל הקהילה הבינלאומית להצטרף לעמדה הזאת של ארצות הברית. מי שרוצה להפסיק את התוקפנות האיראנית, מי שרוצה להבטיח ביטחון, מי שרוצה לקדם את השלום, יתנגד לאיראן ויתמוך בעמדה האמריקנית. כך עושה ישראל. Horacio, unfortunately, my Spanish isn't good enough to say all of this in Spanish, but I want you to know that we speak the same language. It's the language of the heart. We know that what you said is absolutely true. When we met in my office, in your first meeting, a historic visit of a president of Paraguay for the first time in Israel, you said to me something that I shall never forget. You said, remember that there is a piece of Israel in South America. It's called Paraguay. Well, I want you to remember that there is a piece of Paraguay that is here in the Middle East, it is in the State of Israel, here in Jerusalem, in your embassy. Thank you, Horacio. Thank you, Paraguay. Gracias. Thank you, friend. Thank you.
Thank you very much. This is not easy. Eh? Thank you, my friend. Bibi, you said that first meeting. You are Horacio, and I am Bibi for you since then. Thank you for all. Thank you, Israel. I am ending my administration, and I can say that I am blessed. My last life is just to Israel, just to here, to move our embassy. Thanks, God. Thanks, Israel. I will go in Spanish because I think my English is like your Spanish, appreciated Prime Minister. Ready? Profundamente emocionado. Estoy nuevamente en esta tierra sagrada de Israel para ejecutar como presidente de la República del Paraguay la decisión de mi gobierno de trasladar la sede de la embajada de mi país de Tel Aviv a la milenaria Jerusalén. Esta determinación es un homenaje a Israel. Está fundada en una férrea convicción personal y las trascendentes coincidencias en la vida de nuestros pueblos, así como en valores y en los principios que compartimos dentro de nuestra histórica y respetuosa amistad. El voto emblemático de la República del Paraguay en las Naciones Unidas acompañó firmemente en el año 1947 la creación del Estado de Israel en estos santos lugares y por notable coincidencia histórica, el 14 de mayo de 1948, Israel declaró su independencia, como también un 14 de mayo, pero de 1811, se había consumado la independencia de la República del Paraguay. Tanto Israel como Paraguay hemos padecido y superado verdaderos genocidios en nuestra historia. Sufrimos crueles agresiones e injustificables abusos y sobrellevamos con dignidad persecuciones más injustas. Pero sabemos sobreponernos de las grandes dificultades y con determinación marcamos el derrotero de nuestros pueblos con sacrificio, valores y principios, sosteniendo a nuestra aspiración suprema de convivencia pacífica entre las naciones. Israel es verdaderamente una nación admirable. En medio de las adversidades ha consolidado el ideal de democracia y libertad. Se destaca por la igualdad de derechos y obligaciones de todos sus habitantes e invierte decididamente en la educación de su gente. Hoy es líder mundial en innovación científica y tecnológica, con alto nivel de vida de su población y notable desarrollo económico-social. Por todo ello, por compartir caminos, principios y cooperación recíproca, y motivado por mi admiración a esta gran nación que desde milenios transita por la historia, dándose ejemplos de los más supremos sacrificios y valores, no he querido culminar mi mandato presidencial sin antes ofrecer este testimonio palpitante de amistad, solidaridad y respeto al Estado de Israel, trasladando nuestra sede diplomática a la eterna Jerusalén. Compartimos con Israel la revalorización de los derechos humanos, la cultura de la tolerancia y el respeto a las diferencias, así como la visión de un mundo consagrado al reino de la paz, del diálogo, del pluralismo y de condena a todo tipo de fundamentalismo y terrorismo. Tengo la bendición de llegar otra vez desde el corazón de América a la tierra prometida, muy por encima de una pura formalidad para honrar a esta gran nación y fortalecer nuestros vigorosos lazos de amistad sincera, sin duda y sin dobleces. En su visita al Paraguay, su santidad el Papa Francisco nos dijo: los pueblos que olvidan su pasado, su historia, sus raíces, no tienen futuro. Y yo digo que Israel y Paraguay no olvidan, sino que honran su historia y se proyectan con dignidad hacia el futuro. Enarbolando la cultura del diálogo y el respeto entre las civilizaciones y naciones del mundo, digo, finalmente, que los vínculos forjados en naciones, valores, tradición y dignidad entre Israel y Paraguay trascienden los tiempos y las generaciones, y así nuestros hijos y los hijos de nuestros hijos seguirán unidos en el respeto, en el cariño y admiración de nuestras dos grandes naciones. La paz sea con vosotros. Muchas gracias.
Bless all those who come into the house and live in the house. So this is a mezuzah put on the door of the Embassy of Paraguay in Jerusalem.